The documentation process of an education loan seems to be nothing less than a nightmare to many. But it is actually not as tough as you might think. Let me guide you and make it simpler. This is Damini, co-founder of WeMakeScholars, and welcome to the 30th episode of our web series, Loan Flix, Abroad Education Loan Simplified. So at the start of this series, on the fourth episode, we did made a video on the documents required for a collateral loan. So that was a little more difficult to understand because the collateral loan does involve the property papers as the major requirement. But when we come to unsecured loans, the requirement is limited to the applicant and co-applicant's basic documents, the academic documents of applicant, and most importantly, the income documents of co-applicant. So today in this episode, I'll be talking about what is the complete list in detail, and I'll be talking about what is expected from applicant and what is expected from co-applicant, and I'll be also explaining you how to arrange these documents. Please note that you don't have to make notes of this entire list which I'm gonna discuss, because when you talk to WeMakeScholars financial officer, they'll share a link with you to upload the documents, and in that link, the complete list is already given section wise. So let's start. I'm starting to discuss the checklist with the co-applicant's income documents because that is the most crucial, and it is the section which applicants are generally not able to complete. So if your co-applicant is a salaried employee, you would need his 6 months bank statement of the salary account, plus 3 months payslip, sometimes they ask for 6 months also, and finally minimum 2 years of ITR or Form 16. So if your co-applicant is self-employed, you would again need a minimum 6 months of bank statement of the account through which he or she does the business transactions, and minimum 3 years of ITR, and most importantly, the business proof. So now it is way more easier to arrange the business proof if it is a registered business. In that case, you can submit the profit and loss statement, or you can submit the GST registration, etc. But if the business is small, then you'll have to look for things like shop registration and vendor purchase bills, etc. Sometimes the businesses are like very small, like household businesses, like someone is selling saris from home. So in that case, bank does accept the pictures of the stock as proof sometimes, but you need to understand the more organized the business your co-applicant has, it directly means the higher the chances of loan approval. Hence, it is way more easier to get an unsecured loan with a salaried employee as co-applicant than a self-employed person. So to conclude, you need at least one such person who has the above mentioned documents to get an unsecured loan. And that one person has to be preferably from your immediate family, like your parents, your siblings, your parents-in-law, or your parents' siblings, like your father's brother or your mother's brother or sister, etc. So to start your process, you can request a callback using the link given in the description, and WeMakeScholars financial officer will get in touch with you and assist you in the loan process. You need to note that you would get a discount in your rate of interest of at least 0.5 to 1% if you apply via WeMakeScholars rather than applying to these lenders directly on your own. Coming to the academic documents for an unsecured loan, you would require, number one, all the past certificates, that is your 10th, 12th degree, etc. Pertaining to your degree, if you're still studying and haven't got the final degree certificate, then the loan can be approved on your pre-final year or semester grade sheet. Number two, your test scores for all the tests you have written, that is GRE, GMAT, IELTS, TOEFL, etc. Number three, your admit from the university. Kindly note that for a few of the countries, a loan, unsecured loan can be approved without the admit from the university, just based on your test scores. Also, please note that for US, I-20 is not mandatory for the loan approval in any of the banks or NBFCs in India. Moving to the next section, other than the income documents of the co-applicant and academic documents of the applicant, you would require these basic KYC documents for you as an applicant and your father and your mother and your co-applicant if he is someone other than your father or mother. So you would require for all these people, you would require one passport size photograph, PAN card copy, Aadhaar card copy. And for you as an applicant, passport copy is also required. Other than the documents I just discussed, if the applicant is or had been working in the past, then his work experience certificate, last 3 salary slips and ITR copy should be submitted. Though it is not mandatory, but it helps in getting a better rate of interest. As I said in the beginning, speak with our WeMakeScholars financial officer and get the online link to upload all the required documents. When you apply via WeMakeScholars, we check your eligibility with all the banks and NBFCs which offer education loans in India. This will greatly increase your chances of getting the best education loan in the market. Request a call back now using the link given in the video description. One crucial thing I want to highlight here is that most of the times these NBFCs will ask you to share the above mentioned documents with them over an email. And many times the executives will ask you to share it to them on their personal email. Whether you share it on the official email ID or on their personal email ID, this email sharing of documents is not considered to be safe. Many a times these executives leave the job and your documents are left on their personal computers, you know, unattended. Hence, we have designed a secured portal to protect your documents, through which we securely share the documents with the lenders with very limited access to their team members. Hence, the safest way to share the documents with the lender is by uploading it on WeMakeScholars portal. To start your application or to request a callback, please follow the link given in the video description. Please note that WeMakeScholars initiative is funded and supported by Ministry of IT, Government of India, and all the services of WeMakeScholars are completely free of charge. If any of our team members ever ask you for any fee, you can report it by sending an email to hello@wemakescholars.com. Time for my hack. My jugaad for this video is pretty simple. Don't lose hope if you do not have any of the above mentioned documents, which I mentioned as mandatory. Because most of the times, there are alternates available to these documents. So making sure you apply via WeMakeScholars is the best jugaad I would recommend. Because WeMakeScholars financial officer will be able to tell you what are these alternates. And many a times, we can successfully negotiate with the lender to consider your case despite of missing documents and get you the loan which was otherwise rejected bluntly. That's it guys, I hope you liked and understood this documentation packed video. If you found this episode useful, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and please like and share it with your friends. Now you can also let me know if you want me to cover a specific loan topic for you. Please comment on what you want me to make a video on and I'll take it up. Stay tuned for my next episode which will cover step-by-step process of an unsecured education loan. Bye-bye for now.
Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to never miss any updates from us.